Alrighty. Last thing that we're going to do for episode 126 is Fantasy League. So I'm passing this along to Peyton.
All right, well, hard to believe it, but we made it all the way to the end. The conclusion of the Fantasy League has come. We have made it to WrestleMania 30. All the scores have been tallied, and here is how things have ended. In last place, that's fifth place, appropriately with 420 points, is Steven Huego's team. Congratulations, Mr. Steven
Actually, the
Huego's team.
pronunciation is Team Thona.
Well, congratulations on your 420 points.
Good job. Fuck
In
off.
I totally agree with your F daf daf.
Well, in cinco place is Miguel Leon's team, fittingly with the final score of cinco, cinco, cinco. Yeah, that's 555 for you real Americans out there. So Mr. Miguel Leon in fifth place with 555.
Wait, I thought Wago was in fifth place.
You're correct. Miguel's in fourth place.
He's Quattro.
He's Quattro with Cinco, Cinco, Cinco. Whatever. It's not important anyway. It's not important until we get to the top two. So first, let me get to the number three, which is myself with 630 Woo! Points. And now for the top two. In second place, the Drew Crew with 1,340 points. And in first. Having earned over 205 points at WrestleMania alone.
That's fucking stupid.
Mr. Tony Mango with 1,560 points.
And you get to take on the gold medal and this piece of the Craig from Guts.
I can take part of the Andre the Giant trophy that broke off. What's funny is I'm totally leaning back in my chair right now looking all smug.
And for winning first place, you win, and I got a gameplay t-shirt.
Yeah! Nice.
Sure said that joke before, yeah.
All right, so fill us in on what's coming up with the Fantasy League.
Well, I have been sitting, putting in long hours, meticulously typing up new rules for the next season. I have taken note of some of the things that have not worked out as well throughout the season and how we can fix them in the next one. So I will be releasing those rules out to y'all very soon. We are also going to be doing our draft to determine our teams for that sometime in the next 2 or 3 weeks, sometime before Extreme Rules. We haven't booked an exact date yet, but we will certainly keep y'all updated when that is, because those draft specials are always raucously fun as we go and pick our teams. I think that's all we got to tell y'all right now. Stay tuned to keepingkayfabe.com. As I said, I'll be posting the rules where you yourselves can start your own wrestling fantasy league using our rules. I'll even post the spreadsheets. Make it all easy for you, because this isn't really something that's out there. You know, we had to create this ourselves. The first year was sort of like a beta of sorts, and now we're going into the next level of it. We got rules a little bit more fleshed out. The points are going to be a lot harder to get. The stakes are going to be higher. It's going to be harder to get the shakeup, which I think was something that ended up being a little overpowered this first season. So we'll see where things go going into the second season of our Fantasy League.
Credit to Peyton for doing this, too, because this was originally his idea, and he totally took charge of this whole thing. I mean, we obviously do this kind of stuff on Smack Talk and take care of Fantasy League stuff there and everything like that, but it really is more of a keeping kayfabe thing than Smark Out Moment. And I had a lot of fun doing this. I thought that this was really cool. I've seen a lot of positive response from this, too, from a lot of people that really want to get involved in it. And it's a shame that we can't throw you guys in there, because we just literally we can't, because we would
like
have 100 people.
Where there's like 500 people for us to choose from to make our teams.
Right. Yeah.
There's like, you know, what, 40, maybe 50 people on the WWE roster, and only maybe 25 of them you actually want.
And even the 25 of them, there's really only like six. Like, we're going to pick, you know, five people each team. And last time around when we did that draft, I mean, I had like Brodus Clay as my fifth person, and that ended up being like a total waste. We had people like when Brayden and Miguel originally came on board, they had teams of, what was it, like Epico and Primo and stuff were on their team and stuff, because they had nobody else to pick from.
You know what's going to be awesome this year? Being able to pick my own fucking team.
It doesn't matter, because you're all going to lose to Team Mango again. I'm calling it.
Can he be the two-time winner? Well, we'll figure that out. We also have to figure out better prizes. This one, we're just going to give a little bit of advantage of how we determined who's going to be getting what priority in the draft order. We still haven't tallied the scores in that, so we'll be another thing we can announce next week. But we want to come up with a better prize for next year. So if you have some ideas out there about, you know, what first, second, and third place should get in this, let us know. You know, let us know how we can embarrass other people or celebrate those who win.
And I want everybody to just completely smother me in confetti now, just like Daniel Bryan.
I'll give you a jar. I'll give you a jar of pickled Ramyams.
All right, that is it for all the content on episode 126, other than the last thing that we do each and every week before we say goodbye to you guys, the plugs. So, Wago, plugs, go for it.
That was terrible.
Okay. This is a long episode.
Okay, we've got an episode of Addicted to Anime over on Mega Powers Radio, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on April 27th, when we're going to have a big discussion about Pokemon. We've got a big cast on board, so check us out over on facebook.com/addictedanimefans, addictedanimefans.tumblr.com, and yeah, that's about it.
Drew?
I don't really do much nowadays, so I don't really have much plugs. But essentially, the fact I do want to, even though it's kind of, hang on, I just want to thank Mr. Mango and Mr. Tate. Fuck off, seriously. Let me do this for once, okay? I just want to thank those two for, you know, giving me this opportunity to be doing these stuff with them over the past couple years. I just want to say thank you for that, because this means a lot to me.
Are you going to die tomorrow, Drew?
I'm not dying. Fuck off. I wasn't even trying to make it like that, you asshole. Oh, my God. Now I get it.
Every Drew breathes his last breath.
I was going to say just, you know, standard, well, you know what, like, you know, you're welcome, Drew, you know, we love having you and all that kind of stuff. Now, totally, Drew's going to be like, you know what, fuck it, I'm not going to do this anymore.
You know what, it's just, you know, I just want to say thank you guys, you know, because you guys, you know, put a lot of work in all of your stuff, you know, pretty cool guys, you know, anyone who wants to, you know, bother them, you know where to find them. So, yeah, I just want to say thank you for all the stuff, and I can't wait to see what we put out in the future. Go Drew Groove, fuck Team Mango. That's what's up.
Rest in peace, Drew.
Thanks for all the fish, Drew.
Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah.
Why do we have fans?
What the fuck's a fan?
Payton.
Lots of stuff going on, big things popping, little things stopping at Mega Powers Radio this Sunday, April 13th. Tune in for the debut episode of For Real Movie Club. We'll be reviewing four Mel Brooks films, some classics like Blazing Saddles and Young Frankenstein, all of those favorites. We'll be talking about those and just Mel Brooks in general. So join us for that. It's going to be a fantastic episode hosted by good friend of this show, Chris the Dace Man Dace. I know lots of you are always making requests for him to show up. So if you want to hear his voice, tune in this Sunday, MegaPowersRadio.com. And of course, as I said earlier, this coming Tuesday, April 16th, we're going to be having our tribute to the Ultimate Warrior. That starts at 8 p.m. All people are invited to attend and share your Ultimate Warrior memories. It's going to be just a fun little send-off from Mega Powers Radio. Please tune in, share with your friends. Let's make this a night to remember. And of course, if you're a wrestling fan, as I can only assume you are, tune in every single Monday following the conclusion of Raw for the NPR Raw Post Show, where you'll hear all of us here talk about that evening's events and with all the other shows. Excuse me, as with all the other shows on Mega Powers Radio, we invite you to call in and join the conversation and give your opinions about it. And that's about all I got to go on about that. So thank you, Mr. Bango.
Alrighty, guys. Next week, I don't know for sure what the special feature is going to be. I have a couple ideas, but I want to know what you guys think, what you want to see. One of them I had in mind, if you are down with this, Superstar Scores Ultimate Warrior. But we haven't done a belt or berry in a while. We haven't done a top rope list in a little while. I don't know. So if you guys have any suggestions, go ahead, leave a comment below and tell us some different things that you might want to see. And we'll try to figure that out, and we'll have that for you next week. For this episode, that is it, though. And for Stephen Wego, Mike Payton, Drew White, everybody also on the Smarkout Moment team that couldn't be here today, and for myself, this has been another Smarkout Moment, and we are being counted out. See you next time, everybody.
One, two, three. This is the outro, and it is going to... All right, now I gotta restart.
Can we do another unedited outro?
This is the outro, and it's going to suck like everything else I do, but guess what? Get over yourself. Team Mango sucks, and it's all about the Drew Crew and Nancy Grace. Go fuck yourself if you don't know about wrestling. Drew Crew!
Was that Scooby-Doo or Ultimate Warrior? Sounded way too happy.
Oh, okay, my bad. This is the outro, and it's going to suck. I'm Samuel Shaw, and I'm the person going to kill myself. Team Mango sucks, and Drew Crew is the best ever. My Payton and Stephen can just go fuck themselves because they suck at fantasy sports. I don't know which one was better, but pretty good.